Okay, so I've saved the changes from that previous video, and you'll see there that I've got my bold, I've got my ital, and I've got my link. You know, if we want to copy and paste, though, from existing content that's presumably going to be in a Word document or maybe on your existing website or from some other site, and you want to just grab that out of the browser, let's talk a little bit about some of the different scenarios that can play out with that. Okay, so I'm just simply going to highlight and delete the existing content in here. And just as an example, I'm going to switch back over to the filtered HTML view. And essentially what filtered HTML means is we're filtering out certain tags and source code that we don't want because we don't want to bring in a bunch of extraneous styles. We want to keep a nice, clean, pure version of the styles that we've set up and have that be consistent across all of our pages. So I'm going to jump over here to Department of English. And you'll note that they're using a slightly different font. They've got some color in their typefaces. Most of their body fonts are it's a lighter face using a lighter type color on a darker background. So if I try to copy and paste that over, and I just simply drop that into the body field. Now again, it's kind of hard to read because I've got a lighter typeface color on a light background that we're using, but from an author view with that filtered HTML you know, that I have engaged here, look what happens when I save this. Even though I see those styles, as soon as I save it and I go back and review it, it's stripped out and it's filtered all of those extraneous unwanted styles, and it's kept the underline in this case. What it'll also keep is something that's case sensitive, you know, if you've got something capitalized. It's going to keep bold, it's going to keep ital, it's going to keep bulleted lists. So again, it's just kind of protecting us from bringing in a bunch of unwanted formatting. Now, the plus and the minus of being an admin is that in full HTML access, if I drop that in, and again, I just simply pasted it back in and switched my view over to let's see, where are we? Full HTML. Okay, and I'm going to save that because we're trying to give you more access and more. More rights and the ability to go in and do some editing should you need it into the HTML source code. Full HTML is going to allow all that coding to come over. So if I scroll down here, you can see that we basically can't read this because it's white type or light face type on a lighter background. We've got the fonts, we've got the red here in the typeface. Now, to get rid of that, what we can do is we've got a nice feature here, and it's this Word dialog box or this Word icon. When I click on that, it's called Paste from Word, but the intent is basically the same. Whether we're bringing something in from a Word document, and Word will typically embed a lot of extraneous formatting and things that we don't want, just like with the browser. So if we paste this content in to the dialog box and we click Insert, again, note what happens. It serves basically the same person or same function or process of that filtered HTML view. So it allows us to strip out tags that we don't want, and when we save that, we're going to get a nice, clean, pure view of those paragraphs in that content. And so we basically can do it one way or the other. We can bring it in and strip it out, which we would recommend doing because we want to keep those styles clean and consistent. Now, again, should you need HTML access and you need to go in there and do some formatting, you've got this HTML icon. When you click on that, you'll basically get this dialog box and you'll see the source code. And again, we've filtered out and stripped out a lot of unwanted tags and unwanted code by virtue of using that Paste from Word dialog box, but you can still have access and potentially add some things back should you need to. Again, changing colors, changing font size, we would recommend that you don't do that because we want to keep this as consistent as possible. Okay, and any changes that you would make, you would simply hit Update in order to save those.